Subscribers and viewers of our Obi channel, welcome again to this wonderful channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can configure hotspot in MikroTik router in a different way without using the user manager. So kindly sit back, relax, and watch me as I bring this to you. Thank you. So without wasting time, let's launch our Winbox and then start configuring the hotspot. First of all, we need to create an interface which we are going to use as a hotspot. And so I need to quickly come to this side. I can either create a bridge and add multiple interfaces, or I can just create it on a singular interface. So let's assume I want to create my hotspot on a singular interface. All I need to do is to come to IP addresses and then configure my hotspot address, IP address here. And so let's say the IP address is 192.168. Let's say 50. .1/24, okay, and then the interface I want to use for the hotspot is, let's say, Ether 4. You apply and then gives you the network, okay, and then okay. So this is it with creating an IP address for the hotspot you want to use. The next thing is to create a DHCP pole, right? So I'm creating a DHCP pole and I'm naming it hotspot. Okay, so here I can specify, we can either do this in DHCP mode or manually this way. So let's say I want the range of my IP pole to be between 50.2 to 192.168.50.254 or anyone I specify. And then we have next pole, but I don't have any next pole, so you apply and okay. And the next thing is for us to create a hotspot. Okay, so now let me go ahead and create a hotspot from this part of it. And so we said Ether 4 will be used for the hotspot interface, and so I've selected Ether 4. Click on next. I actually had this being part of a bridge, so let me add it to in fact I need to take it out from here. Okay, so now let me start again. So on Ether 4 we have our IP address. Okay, then you proceed and then you follow the processes which has been required here. Okay, so the first thing is your local address of the network in masquerade mode, and then you go further with the address pool of the network. Select certificate. If you have none, you continue with it. You have IP address of SMTP server. If you don't have it, you proceed. The DNS server, the DNS name dot to letsay.tobi.com. Okay, you go next, and then we are done configuring a hotspot here. Now let's change the address per MAC to just singular one, and then we can just leave the rest at default. Apply and okay. Now the next thing, we've created our hotspot server. Now we need to go to the server profile, okay, and do an editing here. So at this part of it, that is on the login tab of the server profile, we have a list of login by methods, like the MAC, login by MAC address, okay, login by HTTP CHAP, which is what we mostly use, login with HTTP PAP, MAC cookie, HTTPS, and trial. Now I just want to use, in this case I want to use MAC cookie, so that when a customer buys data from me, the customer don't have to always log in before he or she can have access to the internet, you understand. And so the main purpose of MAC cookie is to allow any device which has the username and password of a hotspot to quickly get recognized and start using the device without logging in again when the person is around. So that is the purpose of the MAC cookie. So I have just selected the MAC cookie, apply and okay. The next thing to do is to come to the user profile. That is one of the most important aspects. This is where I was talking about, in case you don't want to deal with user manager, you can use this instead. Quickly come to user profile, and so let's create a user profile here, which is going to affect the hotspot we just created, okay. So let's say test hotspot. Okay, so let's proceed with the new hotspot user profile. So on the general tab, we can see the name which I've just typed. The next thing is the address pool. So we are selecting test hotspot, okay. The session timeout of this new hotspot user profile is okay, so we want it to be used for let's say 48 hours, okay. And so after 48 hours, this profile is going to expire. And then the idle timeout, we have none here. Keep alive timeout. So let's say within an hour, if the person is not using the hotspot, he can be logged out, okay. We have status auto fresh, okay. This is with regards to how the status interface can refresh itself. At this part, this is the shared users, like how many profile or how many hotspot username and password can be shared among the users. So let's say 3. This part is in reference to the rate limit. It's in regards to the speed. So let's say 10 meg by 10 meg. Okay. So that is, let's say, RX means download, TX means upload. Okay. And then we add the add Mac cookie. If I uncheck this, it means this profile is not going to be added to the Mac cookie I selected under the server we created earlier. And so I've added it to it, and then this is the period in which the Mac cookie should expire. So if you could remember, I said for 48 hours, right? And so you could just put 48 hours here. And then we have the address list. If you have any, you put it there. If not, you leave it. You have the incoming filter. Okay, this is other configurations you can add to it depending on what you are actually doing. So if you don't have nothing to do with it, you just leave it at default. You leave the rest the same way you see them. If you have nothing to do, if you have anything to do, you can go ahead and do your configuration. The next tab is the queue. So this is the queue. It said before queue. Okay, parent queue. So let's say it said before queue, let's say hotspots queue type. I can just leave it this way, apply. This is scripts. You can type on logon. Example, like welcome to Aobi. That's hotspots. Yeah, you can do like this, copy the same thing, bring it here and edit. That is goodbye. Yeah, you can just simply do it this way, apply and okay. So we are done with our user profile settings, and as you can see, this session time has been configured for 2 days. Okay, and then it can be shared among 3 users, and this is the rate limit. But basically, this is how you can actually configure your hotspots without the use of user manager, and it is still work the same way you want it to work out. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like my videos and share my videos. Your comments are expected as well. Thank you for watching this video.